Hi everybody, this is Jason, the Science Outreach Manager, Life Science Educator, and Art Guy here at the Children's Museum Houston. I'm just calling myself Art Guy because I've been doing a lot of these different art videos and I love art. And this week is our Marvel Mania Wonder Week. And what I decided to do with this particular art project, if you can see it down here, is I took one of my favorite artists, Jean-Michel Basquiat, and I turned Marvel character portraits into his style. So let me tell you a little bit about Jean-Michel Basquiat really quickly before we look at the art itself. He was a pop artist, just like Andy Warhol, where he would take recognizable characters or recognizable products and turn them into an art style of his own. He's actually really known for taking graffiti art and making it a viable art, if you will, which means that it's a worthwhile art that the people who do graffiti do very, very, very beautiful art. As long as they do it like on canvases, as long as they do it as street art, it's better if you do it that way than just going on spraying on someone's building. But he did legitimize it. He said, this is good art. People like Andy Warhol said, this is really good art. We need to legitimize it. And he was known for doing portraits of himself that were really, like, really askew and bizarre looking. You'll see some of his art at the end of this video. We'll make sure to put some up. And he did do some comic book characters. He tended to do DC characters, though. He liked to do The Flash and Superman. He would often mention Thor in his art, but he didn't very often draw Thor. He would draw a crown like this over here, and he would write Thor underneath it. What else is really, really interesting about Basquiat is he would use all different kinds of materials to make his art. He wouldn't just use paint or markers or pencils or India ink. He would use them all. So all this stuff you see right here, he would use to do his art. He would mix the colors in interesting ways without even like really thinking about it. He would just take the colors and mix them up. He would do markers in some points, like here, you can see the Hulk's green is in marker. The Spider-Man red is in marker, but all the background is in paints. Again, mixed up paints, except for the crowns. The crowns are this pure yellow right here. The India ink is my little monkey here, and that's something else he would do. He would just put interesting characters without reason into that. So I just decided to add a monkey for some reason with a tail going around it. And the monkey has a crown as well, but it's a little different looking crown. And you can see over here, there's a crown by Spider-Man's head. So if you're really thinking about the way Basquiat did art, Thor is also in this painting. And one of the really, really interesting things that Basquiat did was he would put writing into his work. So what I did was I decided to put "with great power," but I didn't finish it. Now we all know if we've read Spider-Man, the line is "with great power comes great responsibility," but I'm gonna let you finish that. With great power, what do you think? And then of course I had to put the Hulk smash in because that's Hulk's famous line. But even with the Hulk smash, if you get really close and take a look at it, you can see that even though I did it in paint, I scratched it with pencil. I took this pencil here and I scratched into it to make it have that kind of texture look to it. So he would do things like that. So this right here is really, really reminiscent of a Basquiat painting. And like I said, we'll show you some of his stuff at the end and a picture of him as well. And you can see what a cool looking dude he was and what really, really great art he made. Now, I would like to see you do your own Marvel portraits in Basquiat style. And the great thing about Basquiat style is that it really becomes your own style. He did distort the faces a little bit, like look, the mask here on Spider-Man, you don't see Spider-Man's teeth, but he did a lot of teeth work. So I put Spider-Man's teeth and of course I made Hulk's teeth look really, really prominent. You can see he's got big old teeth. That was a big thing with Basquiat. So you can do things like that. And you don't have to do Spider-Man and the Hulk. There's like, you know, hundreds of Marvel characters that you can do. You can do all of Thor if you like, not just the little Thor I did, the little crown Thor I did. But I really like to see what you do. And again, there's really no rules. You can get a canvas, you can get cardstock, you can get whatever you want, and you can put the portraits in. You can put a giraffe in if you like. You can put your own face next to them if you like. You can put your pet cat in there if you like. I decided on a monkey. But just make sure you get the writing in there, you get all the different styles in there, and you use all the different kind of artistic implements to make your work of art. With that, I am going to say goodbye for now. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you enjoy making your own art. And if you do, please take a picture of your art when you're done and put it on our Facebook, on our Instagram, or on our Twitter, our social medias. We'd love to see what you made. Also, if you're watching this on YouTube, please hit the subscribe button. When you hit that button, you will get notifications of all the cool videos that we do. Our art videos, our story times, our science videos, Mr. O's Oh Wow moments, our Tater Tot Tot Tunes, all of that good stuff. With that, I'm going to say goodbye. I do hope to see you soon. We are reopened. And when I do, I hope you give me a big high five. See you later, everybody.